Hi everyone, welcome to a new video here on my channel, Crafty Cassie. I'm Cassie and today I'm making the project for my Sophie and Toffee elves box. This was my first subscription box from March 2018. This also happens to be my first time working with resin. Since this is a first for me, I kept in a lot of mistakes, mostly so I can show some of the newbie things I did. This particular resin is a 2-to-1 ratio. I measured out two parts A and one part B into a medicine cup. One thing I found is the resin is thick and the bottles are stiff. Squeezing the bottle actually hurt my hand. The hardener bottle was even worse, so you'll notice I give up and take off the nozzle and just pour it into the cup. Then I added some of the pink pigment that came in the box into the resin, mixing it in with a toothpick. For the glitter, I just used what I had in my stash. I used a hollow glitter from a kit I got from Michael's, the iridescent flakies are from Target, the first pink glitter is also from the Michael's kit, and there's a second one. And I got that one from Sally's Beauty Supply. It's actually a nail glitter, but it still works just fine because it is solvent resistant. And I gave all of that a good stir and then added the hardener and stirred that really well. After all the mixing, I poured it into the lid of the trinket box mold, and I used the same toothpick to spread it evenly across the whole mold. I also made sure to really get it touching the edge to make doming a lot easier later on. Now I want to mix the resin for the actual box of the trinket box. Added the glitter and pigment and then the hardener. I mixed a lot, so I really made sure to take my time, fully mix it in, make sure that I got as best of a cure as possible. It is a fairly large mold, so I knew I was going to need a large amount of resin. And I took my time in that mixing before I poured it in. After pouring the resin in the mold, I used a toothpick to make sure it touched the edges. Then I let the whole mold cure for a couple of days in direct sun. I know from my chem class that heat is a byproduct of resin curing, so I figured the sunlight couldn't hurt, but in reality it wasn't much of a help because after several days the box was still not fully cured. Reason being, if you noticed, I actually placed the toothpick down in the middle of the mold after mixing in the glitter and the pigment, which didn't have hardener in it. So now I've got this line of the resin in the center of the mold. And so when I go to pop it out, that sticks to the mold because there was never actually any hardener in that tiny, tiny bit of the mold. After I demold, I then run my finger on the box to see what I needed some more curing time, as well as point out a pool of bubbles on the lid. That is one thing I'm not exactly sure how to correct, because it was kind of like frothy bubbles, not really necessarily anything else, and I think that that is mostly because I was being too vigorous in the mixing process, and so that was all just like micro air bubbles that got into the resin during the mixing process. Now, it is because of that pool of bubbles that determined just how big I painted on the face of my unicorn, which you will see here very shortly. I begin to do. I used white acrylic paint to paint the head. I had to paint several layers to get an opaque face. The paint was just some that I had picked up locally for cheap, same as the brushes. I actually use acrylic paint on my traditional dollhouse, so I have a handful of these bottles, all different brands and such. Also, I used baby wipes to clean up. They're great for everything. Now, using black acrylic paint, I painted the eyes with eyelashes. I have two gold acrylic paints, and for most of the details I use the gold that matched the clay horn closest. Then I use the lighter gold as a highlight color in the hair. Next, using the similar gold, I painted on the inner ear on the white clay pieces, and again, I paint several layers to get opacity. Now I'm just checking that the size looks right, and I set those pieces aside to dry after I smudged the paint on one and have to repaint it. I'm going to dome the top. I used the toothpick from mixing to help get it to the edges. Then with the leftover resin, I sealed the bottom of the trinket box to help with that soft spot. Sadly, I didn't realize that I had set the top on an angle and it didn't dome properly, so now I'm just placing the clay pieces and gluing them down with a bit of E6000. Afterwards, I set the lid aside to let the glue dry a bit, and with a bit more resin, I'm going to seal in the clay pieces and attempt to fix the doming issue. I am doing this with a craft brush from the dollar store, and let it cure overnight. Sadly, not sure if it was the brush or I didn't properly mix the resin, but that final layer had what looked like rivers in it. It did cure, but it was not as shiny and smooth as I wanted it. But that's it. I've completed my very first resin piece. So, what do you think? What would you have done differently? What would you have not thought to do? If you liked this video, go ahead and hit the thumbs up so I know to keep working on my resin crafts and showing you all my trials and tribulations. And if you want to see new videos, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell as well if you want to see them right when I post. Until next time, guys. Bye.